asked, should Isaiah 14:12 be Lucifer or Daystar? And the easy answer is, if your King James Bible says Lucifer, and it does, then it should be Lucifer. Now, of course, to some people that just sounds like a simpleton answer, and I'll admit that it is. I believe the King James Bible. So I have no problem with the answer that whatever my King James Bible says is what it ought to be. Now, you want to play around in your world of unbelief, or listen to teachers who try to rob you of your faith in your Bible that you have in your hands that you read and study from, that's between you and God. I played that game for about 15 years, and I saw how stupid it was. I saw the fools falling one after the other, and that includes the preachers themselves, into unbelief. I sat under a man for a while who claimed to be a King James Bible believer. The next thing you know, he's bootlicking everybody in town and totally useless and about went crazy. I sat under another guy who also claimed to be a King James Bible believer who was just using the New American Standard because that was what they had always used and was interested in changing over to the King James. Once he got me locked in and things changed, and I guess he figured he didn't need me anymore, he not only reneged on his word to change to the King James Bible, but the next thing you know, he's telling me he doesn't believe any Bible is the Word of God, and that includes any original manuscripts, and he starts preaching emergent church nonsense. And that's where this will lead you if you keep reading people who are trying to convince you that there are errors in your King James Bible. Now, I listen to some teachers every once in a while who especially some like J. Vernon McGee and Men of the Past. I'll read stuff by Clarence Larkin, and yeah, they get this wrong. Not a lot, but every once in a while you'll see them make these statements, and I just ignore it. I attribute ignorance as the reason for them saying these things. I just don't believe any intelligent man can know that he's getting his information from the Vatican Codex, and people who try to use the so-called Septuagint and claim that that's the Bible Jesus used, nonsense. Didn't exist. Jesus did not use a Greek Bible. The Septuagint has the Apocrypha in it, and there isn't a Jew who ever lived who accepted that as part of the Word of God. People like Origen and other heretics were involved in giving us the Septuagint. So I just ignore all that crap, because that's what it is. Now, I hope the person who asked this question, anyone else who wants to ask the question, I'm not directing these comments at you as far as, any anger you may hear in my voice, but I do get angry about this because it makes me sick. I'm watching the church go into apostasy and watching one fool after another walk right off the cliff into stupidity and error, and a lot of them destroying their lives, destroying their ministries, destroying their families, destroying their testimony. I have a book, and I believe that book, and I've never seen anybody who sold out and really believed that book to do that. But I've seen plenty of people who start believing these nonsense lies about the King James Bible, believing there's error in it. I've seen them just make a wreck of things. And so I want to shoot straight to you and give it to you with a warning. But let's get down to some of the issues that are brought up. The Hebrew word is Hallel, with the vowels put in there. H-E-Y-L-E-L is the transliteration. It's Hey, Yod, Lamed, Lamed, and then you add the vowels by looking at the Masoretic vowel markings. I'm not going to get into all that, though, because I just simply believe that God gave us a book for these last days. 1611, He gave us a King James Bible. The only changes that needed to be made from that first printing was to go ahead and get the Apocrypha out from between the Testaments. It was not included as part of the Bible, but it caused some confusion. And there was also some type and font issues. The F's looked like S's. The spelling was just free-for-all in English. Y-E-E-R-E or Y-E-A-R for year and that sort of thing. But once those little things are taken care of, the content remained the same. We had an infallible book. It has produced the greatest period of soul winning and church building and fundamental Bible-believing missions and ministry in all of church history. And it's for these last days that he gave us this book so that we don't have to spend all of our time like a bunch of pencil-necked geeks sitting around yakking about the original Hebrew and the original Greek and talking like scribes. No, we can talk like Jesus and the apostles. You know, they always say, well, Hillel is actually a word that could be translated as star of the morning, or morning star, or day star. It's a really unfortunate rendering we have in our King James Bible. All we have to do is look at our lexicon and we can see blah, blah, barf. And it's nonsense. You're talking like a scribe. You need to quit and go get a real job if that's the way you preach and teach. You're not a preacher. None of the guys who were called of God in the Bible, Old Testament prophets, John the Baptist coming into the New Testament under Jesus and Paul, and none of the apostles, you never hear them preach like that. They didn't have the originals. They had copies. They had Hebrew copies of the Old Testament as the New Testament was being written. And then Peter and others had some of the copies of the Gospels and Pauline epistles there towards the end. They didn't look at it and say, well, this is an unfortunate translation, and this copyist error obviously is a gloss that we should blah, 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 barf. And that's all it is barf. It's scholastic nonsense, academic vomit. That's all it is. It's based on nothing. You have in the new versions, the New American Standard translates it, O Star of the Morning. The NIV says, O Morning Star. And then you have like the New King James Bible has Lucifer, but then the footnote says literally day star. So then someone says, well, the King James translators put in their footnote that the variant reading of O day star. Yeah, there's a couple things about that. It's number one, they didn't say literally. But number two, it is in a footnote. Did you notice that? What did they put in the text? Lucifer. You want to know why they did that? Because it's supposed to be Lucifer. The text is about a person, and the name of the person is Lucifer. And it's insane to take the name, and instead of translating the name, you then give the definition of the name and translate the definition of that name. It's just amazingly stupid. There are places in the context where that kind of thing can happen, but in the context where you're talking about a person and he's being addressed and he's being named, how art thou fallen from heaven, O Lucifer? He's being named. The context demands that the name be translated, and it's translated Lucifer. Now, if it wasn't going to be translated Lucifer, then you'd have to translate it with the definition like they do in this case in the new versions. They say, O day star, O star of the morning, whatever. Imagine how unreadable the Bible would be if they constantly did that. Go look up every time you see the word Moses. And instead of the word Moses, it says to draw out water or to draw out of water. Think about that. The Bible wouldn't make any sense. The word Moses is in 784 verses in the Bible. Can you imagine trying to read the Bible in 784 times instead of telling you they're talking about Moses? They say, thus saith the Lord to draw out of water. It's just nonsense. And so forth. It just would make the Bible into a load of nonsense. The word John. Jehovah has been gracious. Now go every time you look up the name John, instead of giving it as John, give it as the definition. Jehovah has been gracious. It makes no sense. The bottom line is, the King James Bible is right. Don't ever doubt it. And in this case, particularly, keep the God-revealed name of our enemy before he fell, Lucifer. Isaiah 14:12 should say, quote, how art thou fallen from heaven, O Lucifer, son of the morning? How art thou cut down to the ground, which didst weaken the nations? That's what it should say.